What's up, y'all, man? It's me, JT, back again with a brand new video for y'all. And I would like to welcome back my old subscribers. What's up, y'all, man? Welcome my new subscribers. Welcome, 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 man. I don't know the fuck you are, but welcome, man. There's snacks in the lobby. There aren't any snacks in the lobby. I'm lying.
Oh, brother, this guy stinks!
But what I do have is my first reaction to Rina Sawayama's Sawayama album, man. Now, this isn't my first video on Rina Sawayama. I've done videos before on her if you watch my videos. Now, Rina Sawayama has a very unique sound, man. She's pop, but it's like next level pop, man. It's almost like so many different genres mixed into one. It's like a melting pot of like rock, rap, and everything, man. It's such a different sound of pop that we haven't really heard before. I don't know if she took all the elements from each pop song and just made it her own, but it's so unique, man. It's very different from like the pop songs of like yesteryear and all this other stuff, like Britney Spears and Christina Aguilera. It's very experimental, man. And I'm hoping to hear a lot of those mixtures of sounds and different genres in this new album that I'm about to listen to. And yeah, I'm excited, bro. So without further ado, let's get into Rina Sawayama's Sawayama album, man. Track one, Dynasty.
I'm losing myself.
See, this is what I'm talking about, man. She doesn't stick to one sound, man. This sounds very grungy. In the beginning, man, it sounded like some opera type shit. I wonder if she took opera classes before, but let's get back into this song, bruh. Alright, y'all, that was track one, Dynasty, man. See, fresh off the bat, she's coming with something different, man. That kind of sounded like a song Christina Aguilera could have did back in the day, but like in her dirty years, like the dirty era, she could have made a song like this kind of. This also had like elements of like grunge music a little bit, man, to me at least. But yeah, I like this intro. It's showing the different genres she is about to be using, because I know it's going to switch up at some point in this album. But yeah, let's move on to track two, XS. Hold up, y'all, I've heard this song before, man. I've only heard like the hook before, but I've never heard the beginning of this song, bro. Like, that took me off guard, because I thought it was gonna be something totally different, but it's this song. It's the song I've already heard already. Alright, y'all, that was track 2, XS, man. I like that track. Again, I've heard it before. And it kind of reminded me of like NSYNC in the later days when it was about to break up and it was getting older and he started talking more sensual or whatever in the pop industry, however they want to say it or whatever. It kind of reminded me of that mixed with a little bit of guitar in the middle. But overall, it was a dope track. I really like it, man. Next, we got track 3, Shut the Fuck Up.
Oh,
Oh, I love this. Y'all, that was track three, Shut the Fuck Up. Yeah, man, that was a dope ass track, man. I really like that one, man. That kind of reminded me of like a WWE intro. No, matter of fact, it reminded me of like what's that movie, it reminded me of The Crab. This could be on The Crab soundtrack, man. Not The Crab 2, because no, The Crab, like, who. It also had a sound reminding me of like the band The Breeders and Veruca Salt and stuff like that, man. I'm a sucker for like grunge music from the 90s and stuff. So yeah, this felt right in my ballpark. I really like this kind of music, man. And this was a dope ass track, man. It felt like I was going to punch somebody in mosh pit and knock their damn teeth out. But next up, we got Comme or Just Garcon, Like the Boys. What are you doing now? Might be a favorite. Oh my God. Alright, y'all, that was track four, Comme or Just Garcon, Like the Boys, man. That was a dope ass track, man. I like this track, man. It really reminded me of like some Vogue type music, man. I could see like a modeling agency using this in one of their runway shows or something. And also, I think Rina Sawayma, I'm sorry if I mispronounced your name, but I think Rina Sawayama is a model also. So this kind of makes sense in that landscape to me. That she would do like a song like this, but yeah. Now we on to track five, Akasa Sad. Alright, y'all, that was track five, Akasaka Sad. I like this one, but I don't think I like it as much as the ones before this one. To me, this was like the most futuristic one so far. This one sounded kind of like it could have been on Ex Machina or something like that. It almost sounded like a chemical experiment in there, man. Like she was going through all the chemicals to put together a science experiment or something like that. But yeah, man, this was a cool track, man. It was decent, but I don't like it more than the other ones before this. All right, y'all, we on track six, Partisan.
Boarding school for the seventh time. I know I feel the mist.
All right, so that was track 6, Partisan. This was like okay track to me, man. It kind of reminded me of 80s pop, but she put a little twist on it and stuff and made it her own, like made it like a little bit more cyber sounding and a little bit more futuristic a little bit. But yeah, this kind of reminded me of like the 80s pop era, man. Just with her little twist on it, man. All right, y'all, now we on track 7, Love Me For Me. Alright, y'all, that was track 7, Love Me For Me, man. I like this track, man. I love how it feels. I really like the message in it, of course, man. If you don't love yourself, how can you love anyone else? That's a dope message, always. This one was less experimental to me. Probably one of the least experimental, but at the same time, still a great track. I really liked it. I know I'm not saying much about these songs, man. It's hard to formulate a good ass analysis on a song when you in the middle of it, but man, all I can really say is, man, I like this track and it was a dope track. Next track we got Bad Friend. Of course, I've heard Bad Friend the remix before, but I've never heard the original version, so this will be new to me. Let's go.
We ran through the bright Tokyo lights, nothing to lose, summer of 2012, singing our hearts out to Carly. Making fun of our lovers, getting kicked out on the street. Oh, we were better, making sparks and shit, but then I'm a bad friend, so I did everything. Cause I'm a bad friend. Cause we fell out, what was that all about? Maybe I
y'all, that was track 8, Bad Friend, man. This one was different from the remix, man. This one sounded like a calm down, like a this one almost sounded like a ballad to me. The remix sounded like a more of a heightened version of it, man. This one is very kind of laid back, but at the same time very experimental. I really like how different this one is from the remix, man. The remix is very heightened energy, man. It has more energy to it, but this one is very calming. It makes you think a little bit, man. I really like this track. I like it a lot. Next up, we got track 9, Fuck the World Interlude. Thank you.
to be the tallest, but we drift so dumb.
That was track 9, Fuck the World Interlude. I don't really have much to say about this song besides I like the instrumental on it, and I like how she was using her voice on there. I really like the hook to it, and it was a great track, man. I really liked it. All right, y'all, we got track 10, Who's Gonna Save You Now. Alright, so that was track 10, Who's Gonna Save You Now. I really like this track, man. It almost sounded like a concert going on, man. And you can see her on the stage performing next to a dude with a guitar, and she just blazing her damn vocals and stuff like that, man. I really like this one. At the end, the guitar came in. It almost sounded like a soft rock guitar solo on there, man. I really like this track. I like it. Next up, we got Tokyo Love Hotel.
You got that movie star glow. You got them asking to even know. They don't know. Yeah. They don't know you like I know you. Thought I was original, but after all, I guess this is just another. I just want your love all to myself. Everybody's saying that took your love hotel.
All right, y'all, that was track 11, Tokyo Love Hotel. This was a good track, man. I really like how she was using her voice on here. And it also kind of, again, reminded me of the 80s a little bit, man. It reminded me of 80s pop music. But now we're on the track 12, Chosen Family.
Tell me your story and I'll tell you mine. I'm all ears. Show me the rivers cross the mountain scale. Show me who. Settle down, put your bags down.
All right, y'all, that was track 12, Chosen Family. I really like the message in that, man. It doesn't matter if you are blood or not, man. If somebody loves you, then hey, that's all that matters. Y'all are family. I could somehow see Sam Smith on this for some reason. I could see him on there for whatever reason. I could see him on there. In the beginning, it kind of reminded me of Fireflies by Owl City. It kind of reminded me of that song. But as it went on, it transitioned into something else, like what Sam Smith could probably be on. But I really like the second part of this, how she switched up the beat on this song, man. I really like that. And yeah, man, I like Chosen Family. It was a good track. I like this one. But let's move on to the last song of this album, Snake Skin. Alright, so that was track 13, Snakeskin, the last song on this album, man. I like how in the beginning it sounded like almost like a opera going on, but as it went on, it started turning into something totally different, which is normal for her music, man. It always turns into something way different from what it is. But yeah, man, I like this track, man. It sounded very grand. It almost sounded very dramatic in some senses, bruh. But yeah, I like this track. I like Snakeskin. But yeah, man, this concludes my Rina Sawayama album reaction. This was a decent album, man. I can see why people would want this to be nominated for a Grammy, because it's bringing something different to the pop table that we haven't heard in a minute, man. It's usually some normal pop songs, man, about love and all this other stuff. But she's bringing some different sounds to the mix, man. And I really respect it. If I had to rate it on first listen, I would probably give it an 8.5. It could possibly change along the lines of when I go back and listen to it some more, but yeah, man, this was a good album, man. But anyways, man, like, comment, subscribe, tell me y'all favorite song from this album in the comment section. Tell me what y'all rate this album, and yeah, man, I've been JT, and I'm out, man. Peace.